Skywatch Media News for August the 6th, 2019. Here's what's happening. When you picture Greenland, you most likely visualize a vast country that is both harsh and icebound. Our generation never considered the possibility that this massive land would one day be strewn with melted ponds and where once small streams would suddenly be transformed into raging rivers. Certainly it never crossed our minds that this land would be subjected to tundra wildfires and to plumes of smoke. But this is precisely what Greenland looks like today, and it wasn't supposed to happen for another 50 years or more. Imagery from social media, from expeditions on the ground, and from satellite data paints a bleak picture of the changes happening in Greenland and what they may mean for our future. Last week, the historic heat wave that swept across northern Europe and the Arctic regions affected conditions at the highest reaches of the Greenland ice sheet, where temperatures quickly rose above freezing for the first time since July of 2012, and for only the third time in the past 700 years. Surrounding the margins of the ice sheet, the glacial ice melted at an alarming rate, roughly 60% of its surface ice, losing 11 billion tons in just one day, with daily losses exceeding any point in the past 70 years. In fact, the ice sheet sent 197 billion tons of fresh water into the Atlantic in the month of July. The latest heat wave that contributed to the meltdown was unusual in that a large dome of warm air came from the east, and this was associated with the remnants of a record-setting European heat wave. Temperatures at the summit station, which is Greenland's highest point at 10,660 feet, hovered above the freezing for nearly 11 hours, which was nearly twice as long as the last melt event that took place back in the year 2012. But like 2012, the melt reached the highest elevation of the ice sheet as seen from satellite and ground-based observations. An image composite comparing the summer of 2018 and 2019 show a much larger area of bare ice and meltwater lakes. Weather stations located on the ice sheet have recorded greater melt rates this year than what occurred back in the year 2012. In July of 2012, the public watched video of meltwater runoff that was racing down the Watson River. In 2019, we are seeing disturbing images of tremendous ice calving as well as surface melting on ponds and lakes across Greenland. In Greenland's northern tier, near the Thule Air Force Base, located about 1,000 miles from the North Pole, temperatures were hovering near 60 degrees, while temperatures closer to the Greenland coast were registering above 70 degrees. The abnormal temperatures have contributed to ice margin collapse, to meltwater surging into new channels, and to the eventual flow of fresh water into the Atlantic. The historic heat, along with low levels of precipitation, has sparked wildfires along the western fringes of Greenland. The imagery taken from above show fires burning in treeless areas and consuming the mossy wetlands. These fires burn deep into the peatlands and tundra, which releases previously trapped methane gas into the atmosphere. The ice mass loss that was experienced in Greenland in the past week was approaching levels that were not expected for the next 50 years, based on model data. What is profoundly clear now from what is being observed is that the Greenland ice sheet is rapidly deteriorating, fueled by changes occurring in our atmosphere and the heating of the Earth's crust. And it's all happening much sooner than scientists had anticipated. It's happening in dramatic fashion, and it's quickly unfolding before our eyes. For many years, Alaskan Native tribes have predicted the disappearance of ice in the Arctic regions, that the winds would no longer be bitter cold like it once was in their homeland. Their prophecy, handed down through generations, now appears to be coming true. Alaska has had its warmest year in recorded history, which has contributed to thinning ice and the scarcity of winter snow. It has not gone unnoticed by the native elders. The tribal prophecy spoken by the elders has become a dire reality for many, as the winds have changed, and this has had a profound effect on the lives of native tribes who dwell in the Arctic. For them, it is coming to pass. As you look to the sky, remember these things, for the times have changed, and the people of this world who have contributed the least will be those who will have the most to lose in a rapidly changing environment. Thanks for watching.